Hello and welcome back, guys, to another episode of BioShock here on the Proda Squad. As always, I'm Proda. And so when I came back to the game, it ended up having to be a fetch mission. So instead of making everyone sit there while I went and found all the pieces, I just kind of went and found all the pieces. There we go. Scared myself. I was like, wait, didn't I find all the pieces?
Does it look like it's a real bomb? It better. You got to put it on the core, past the other barrel.
Tell me what I have to do.
The needle noses knew what the hell they were talking about.
So now we gotta get back to the big door, because remember, we were on our way to murder Andrew Ryan, and he has that big electrical door that supposedly you can't lock, you can't pick it, you know, or nothing, hack it, nothing. So, we are going to use a EMP that I just built. I heard an electric boy. I'll take all that, though.
Nice!
Oh, so that way.
Come on,
oh, it was
then.
Downstairs, really?
Fight me properly!
Whatever you say, I'm following the arrow. Ah. This door. But yeah.
Looks like the ocean's got an itch to retake this corner, Rapture. This happened right after the start of the war. Read about it in the papers. Head on in. I'll see what I can dig up to help. I'm no engineer, but if I read these plans right, you can channel that magma flow using the redirect valve. It'll boil off that water right quick, and you'll be able to reach the core. But Ryan's sure to take notice. Might want to set up a perimeter just to be certain.
Yeah, whatever. Just tell me where to put the... redirect the magma flow.
Will these creatures kill you? Even I don't know. As you drag me closer to the abyss, you pull yourself right along with me. Quick death, Doctor. It will be preferable to what you will learn.
Ah, fuck. I guess I have to deal with you assholes. Faster. New wave is coming, hurry up. Ah, fuck it. That it? Okay. Damn, that was fast. Core time, it's core time. We can go for the core time. I find it funny that this isn't even my fight. You know, like, I just crash landed in a plane. I had nothing to do with any of this.
So far away from your family, from your friends, from everything you ever loved. But for some reason, you like it here. You feel something. Can't quite put your finger on. Think about it for a second, and maybe the word will come to you. Nostalgia.
I do like it here.
What did Atlas offer you? A piece of my plundered city? Mark my words, your only reward will be a knife in the back.
I don't disagree with that. Ah. tell if that's the city making the noise. I don't disagree with that sentence either. Ooh, guys, after I finish recording this, I'm going to be ordering my new microphone and potentially a camera. I'm not sure about that one, but definitely a new microphone. So get ready for some grade A audio. I have a couple new toys I want to get for the channel. I'm excited. For those of you guys who use cameras, what cameras do you use? I was looking at maybe using a GoPro so that way I could use it for more than just, like, oh, hold on.
Even in the Book of Lies, sometimes you find truth. There is indeed a season for all things. And now that I see you flesh to flesh and blood to blood, I know I cannot raise my hand against you. But know this, you are my greatest disappointment. Does your master hear me? Atlas! You can kill me, but you will never have my city! My strength is not in steel and fire. That is what the parasites will never understand. A season for all things. A time to live and a time to die. A time to build and a time to destroy!
Oh, Jesus. Things are kinda heating up a little bit down here.
Come now, my child. There is one final thing to discuss.
Yeah, I suppose there is, sir.
What? Ryan set the core to self-destruct. This is different than what you did. He's got a mind to take down the whole damn city. Get in there and whack the chunk before the whole joint blows!
I was gonna say something. Oh, Armin, how do you pronounce it? Armin Shimmerman, the voice actor for Ender Ryan. I absolutely just love the way he did it for this game. I mean, it's going into the end game now. I don't really think I need anything. I'm not even going to try and hack these because I'm just going to get hurt. Actually, I have a hack trap. Auto hack. And I could buy another one. I guess I'll just buy. I have six, that's fine. I'll see ya. Hopefully there's not a timer, because I don't remember which way to go. That's the way I came from. That's probably... I have some of this one, right? Oh, there's stairs. Stairs. Nowhere to go from up here. Oh, just there. Secrets. I cannot see a damn thing. I don't know how much ammo I have. Wasted. buddy. We got 14 shots with the shotgun. I don't know why it's still giving me money. I'm pretty sure this is the end game here. Okay, thanks for all the goodies.
The assassin has overcome my final defense, and now he's come to murder me. In the end, what separates a man from a slave? Money? Power? No. A man chooses. A slave obeys. You think you have memories. A farm. A family. An enemy. A crash. And then this place. Was there really a family? Did that airplane crash? Or was it hijacked? Forced down. Forced down by something less than a man, something bred to sleepwalk through life until they are activated by a simple phrase spoken by their kindly master. Was a man sent to kill or a slave? A man chooses. A slave obeys. Come in. Stop, would you kindly? Would you kindly? Powerful phrase. Familiar phrase.
Would you kindly?
Would you kindly get this?
Would you kindly find that?
Would you kindly find that?
Would you kindly find
that? Would you kindly get this?
Would you kindly head to Ryan's office and kill the son of a bitch?
Sit, would you kindly? Stand, would you kindly? Run! Stop! Turn. A man chooses. A slave obeys. Kill! A man chooses!
So we've been played this entire time. This entire time we've been being used and lied to. And what happens if I don't? What if I want to be a man? What if I don't want to be a slave? Can I let this place go up in flames? I really don't remember. You unlocked an episode of the director's commentary. Play it now or view it later. I'm curious to see if I can just let this place blow up. I really don't remember. Cause I'm nobody's slave. La la la, let's let this place blow up. I don't know if we can. I think it's just gonna do this. I think we have to do it. Let's just conform. shocker. So, shocker. Hey, there's a hole. Meow. So this is going to be a little bit of a longer episode, but here's the but. It's almost done. I'm pretty sure we can get through this. Might be like 30, 35 minute episode. I'm hoping to keep it under 40, but I'm pretty sure this is pretty much it.
Welcome back, child. Welcome to the city where you were born. You are angry at Fontaine, yes? Now you know the truth. You are his tool, brought back to Rapture to save him. You have saved many of my little ones. I owe you a debt. While you sleep, I undo some of Fontaine's mental conditioning. His control is no longer complete, but he can still pull some very unpleasant. Made your mind with many locks and keys. Fontaine has most of those keys, but not all. Su-chan designed your mind, taught Fontaine to control you. You might find answers in Su-chan's flat in Mercury Suites.
Okay. I think I might be mistaken. I think there's more to this game I don't remember. I don't remember having to kill Fontaine. Didn't make sense.
He's the one who saved me.
You're welcome. Anyways, so I will call this episode here just because I don't know how much longer it's going to be. I don't know if this is like a quick mission or a long one, so we're going to end it there. But hopefully next time that we play this, we'll finish it. But no guarantees because I really don't remember this. I thought I did. Oh, I have to follow that one. Okay, anyways. I'm going to go ahead and leave this off here, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Until then, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you're enjoying it. Also, subscribe if you're new, and ring the bell because I upload every day. Thank you so much, and I'll see you later. Bye.